Let me begin by asking, how well do you know your city? And by this question, I do not mean how well do you know where the bus station is or the railway station is. Neither do I mean whether you know where the biggest malls in Trivandrum. There are no malls in Trivandrum, but at least places like Style Plus or where the cinema halls are. For an archaeologist, I'm an archaeologist, for me it is but natural to be interested to know where are these old establishments, for instance, as I said, the railway station, when did it come up in its present position, why did it come up in that particular position? But every one of us, you don't have to be an archaeologist or an historian to be interested to know about your past. But I think wanting to know a little bit about your past is inherently there in each one of us. We are interested, if nothing else, we want to know about our grandparents. We want to know about our ancestral roots, because most of us, Malayalis who have grown up in other cities also, who has no direct connection with Trivandrum or any other part in Kerala, still want to know a little bit about where they come from, or where did their grandparents come from, and what were times like during the grandparents, where they lived, how were things around at that point in time. So it is touching upon this aspect in every human being to know a little bit about their past, which makes history interesting. History is actually not about kings and queens and dates, wars. History is about us. History is what we as human beings lived in the past, did in the past, and made this whole culture that we are living in today. So it is not important that, you know, you worry about when did the Travancore dynasty come about or when did the Cochin dynasty come about. Those are also important. The dates are important. What I'm saying is the larger picture of history is what is interesting, what makes learning history interesting. Similarly with heritage, we often focus on the grand structures, the beautiful palaces, the beautiful temples, the beautiful churches and the mosques that we see around, as if that is all what is heritage. So often we think, oh, we don't have a Taj Mahal in Trivandrum. Wish we had a Taj Mahal in Trivandrum. But that's not needed, because heritage is not measured by the grandeur of the structure. Heritage is everything that we cherish from the past, which we want to keep alive, which we want to sustain, which we want to protect. So even our, what we call the intangible heritage, that is our arts, our crafts, our traditions, our songs, everything, our nature, actually the beautiful green cover that we have around Kerala is also part of our heritage. So Heritage Walk Trivandrum initiative was started in 2013 when I had the opportunity to make Trivandrum my home base in 2010, I was surprised that Trivandrum, despite being a capital city, didn't have such an initiative called the Heritage Walk, wherein people could actually approach a group or an organization and seek their help to explore your locality, your very regional locality. Because heritage is, as I said, it's not something in grand buildings or structures. It is in every nook and corner, every traditional household or every traditional structure or any traditional art form is part of heritage. So I was surprised that we didn't, because living in bigger cities in the country and abroad, I realized Heritage Walk was very popular there. You could approach any state organization and ask them to, you know, help you out with a walk or any kind of, whether it is a bus ride through the city or walking through the city or a tram ride through the city was possible. So here in Trivandrum, I was at a loss, because again, as growing up elsewhere, I always say that the histories of regional regional histories, as you see, does not feature in our mainstream textbooks. Unless you are a student of the SSC syllabus, state syllabus, it is a very rare chance that you get to hear about the history of Kerala in an ICSE syllabus or in a CBSE syllabus. You hear about Alexander the Great, you hear about the Mauryas, the Guptas, and you know, all these big dynastic rules that we have, the Mughals. Everyone has heard about Akbar. But even me, despite being a Malayali from Thrissur, I had never heard of Marthandavarma. Ariyam Thirunal Marthandavarma. As an archaeologist, I'm absolutely well-versed in the geological history of Kerala, the prehistory of Kerala, the proto-history, and the fantastic international trade links, the spice trade links that we had. All these aspects is part of my subject, and it's what I teach. I used to teach. So that is all known to me. But this local histories that we have, what happened in the Cochin royal family or the Cochin principality, or what happened in the Travancore principality, or what happened in the Malabar principality, was absolutely not, I hadn't learned it anywhere. So when I made Trivandrum my base, this was like my mission. I had to know more about Trivandrum. So when I came here, as I said, there was no such group where I could join and work. I made friends with people who were equally interested in history and who had a far better knowledge of this, what I call the micro history of Trivandrum. And that's how we formed a group. I initiated this group. We were like four or five of us friends together. And this was in 2013, October. Incidentally, we are celebrating the fourth year anniversary this month. And we have organized a little celebratory exploration to a slightly far away place. So we got together and we started this. And the beauty of this initiative is that it is not meant exclusively for historians or archaeologists or students of architecture or conservation and restoration. This is open to everybody because, as I said, everybody is interested in history at different varying levels. So it was so encouraging. A walk which we started in 2013 with just 15 people joining our walk has now grown to a Facebook membership of 5,000 people. And at any given walk, we walk one last Sunday of every month in the morning. And in any given walk, we have at least 50 to 60 people joining us. Sometimes some of my friends ask me, "You've been walking for 4 years. Itna kya hai dekhne ke liye, you know, Trivandrum mein? What is there to see so much in Trivandrum that you're still walking, you know?" But the fact is, heritage, as I said, is there in every nook and corner. In every gully of Trivandrum, you will find a house which was significant in the history, micro-history of Trivandrum. You will find a location which was significant in the micro-history of Trivandrum. So it is very entertaining, educative to actually walk these by-lanes and explore. Instead of making a beeline to the very touristy attractions like we have, obviously the Padmanabha Kshetram is the landmark, that glorious temple is the landmark, and the east fort of Trivandrum is pretty much the core area around which the city of Trivandrum came up. But heritage of Trivandrum doesn't stop at east fort. People come from Kovalam who make a beeline to the East Fort area, and they see the Kudra Maliga and a few structures and they are done with it. But that is not the case. In fact, when we started, we went and first exploration we did was in an area called Peta. Many of you would be familiar with Peta area. Locals of Trivandrum would know, but a person who has who is new to Trivandrum or has barely been here for a couple of years may not know where is Peta. But what is Peta? Why is it called Peta? Why is it significant? It is so interesting to know that Peta was the first entry point into the city, the temple city of Trivandrum. When goods would alight at the Vallakadava, people would take it in the bullock carts and they would have to reach Peta, and they would have to actually give a toll. They would have to give a tax there. Only then they could enter. And entry into the main temple area was only allowed to the Hindus. So, you know, Peta is even today the largest settlement where you have non-Hindus. The oldest church existing in Trivandrum is at Peta. The oldest mosque which existed in Trivandrum is in Peta. In fact, it's very interesting to note that Kayangulam Kochuni was buried in the mosque in Peta. So these are little tidbits which makes understanding of Trivandrum's history interesting. And it's not just Trivandrum. It is also, this is an excellent model to, you know, redo or replicate in districts like Kollam, Cochin, Calicut, on any of these districts. In fact, Kollam is the oldest main trade center in India, in the whole of India actually. Very little people know about it. So these aspects is what I would like to do, you know, in the next, as you say, in the next 10 decades, that is what my vision is, to replicate this model of Trivandrum, Heritage Walk Trivandrum, in the other districts of Kerala. And why is it important at this particular juncture is I have felt in my experience and understanding of living in other cities, smaller cities like Trivandrum are in this throes of development, you know, they are all in a big rush to become what they call smart cities, you know. So we want to do away with anything that comes in the way of becoming a smart city. We cut our trees, we demolish old buildings, we just want to widen our roads as if it's going to solve all the problems. Depending, I mean, when we consider the number of cars or number of vehicles we are pushing onto the road every day, no cutting of trees is going to help traffic problems. But in this mad rush for development, it is high time we take a step back and engage, I mean, people like me are engaging with the government, state government, municipal corporations and all, giving, I mean, we are integral parts of their strategic planning about this development of, I mean, making Trivandrum into a smart city. But it's a different matter how much of this is actually going to be considered, you know. To put on paper, it all looks nice, but how much of it actually gets executed is another matter. But it is high time we take a step back and see that how we can move ahead with our strategies for development, keeping in mind the importance of both, not just our structural heritage, not just our cultural heritage, but also environmental heritage that we have. So with movements which actually many of my friends feel that this Heritage Walk Trivandrum has become a movement, it has taken a movement proportion, which I'm very delighted to know that. But it is these kind of sensitizing programs, initiatives, which help people to take a step back and be sensitive, be accommodative to, because there are enormous innovative ways which we can go ahead keeping these along, I mean, taking these values or taking these importance of heritage along with us. So spare a thought for our heritage around us. Thank you.